one of the nice ones with sensible drives. What else could I be? I'm one of the good guys who plays with their children and totes on and pampers their wives. But there was that night in Hawaii on a business trip that my mind has suffused with a mystic glow. She was someone's friend, and she had this smile. We were on the beach, and we walked a while, and I watched the wind billow in her hair, and I knew, we knew there was more to share. I could feel the ground start to glow, like volcanoes starting to blow, and the waves were loud. We were all alone. We had left the crowd. Not a soul would ever have known. But I stopped. Because that isn't me. I'm one of the good guys, one of the smart ones whose virtue survives. Firm as a tree, one of the good guys who trades a flash of food to build a warmer fire. Denies himself a treat to shoot for something higher, and that's the part that's sweet, that only the good guys know. That's not the end. As you suspected, time flipped some pages. I'm now 44. There's money to spend. The kids are in college. My wife's back in art school. We just bought a house at the shore. But sometimes at night, in the stillness, lying wide awake, as the wife I still desire sleeps by my side, I can feel the wash of the perfumed air as my mind is drowning in blowing hair. And although I know that my life is blessed, I am teased by thoughts that it's second best, and the vision seen in my head of the lives that I could have led. They are all still there. I can change my fate. I can find them. I must find them before it's too late. But I wake and say no. Oh, well, why defend all of us good guys, strangling in plenty, yet whining for more? Truth is, my friend, just between good guys, it's not which road you take, which life you pick to